And the following contest is set for one fall for the New South Heavyweight Championship.
To have. I'm excited for this one. Let's hand it over to Cody Coons.
First, the challenger from Wilmington, North Carolina, by way of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 184 pounds, the last bastion of professional wrestling, Colby Corino. And his opponent, from Hartselle, Alabama, weighing 185 pounds, he is the New South Heavyweight Champion, Adam Priest.
There we go. That is what it's about right there, folks. Take a good, hard look at that gold. That is what Colby Corino is laser focused in. His debut in New South Wrestling, and he can walk out of here New South Heavyweight Champion.
The biggest prize in Southern Wrestling, Carmen. Big gold has certainly attracted a lot of competitors.
I think it's respectable of Adam Priest, too, giving a chance to all these up-and-comers here in New South, all these debuting wrestlers. Giving him a shot at the gold. We saw it against Eric Royal. Now here he is, second-generation superstar Colby Corino. Of course, son of the legendary Steve Corino. Mm-hmm. We know the whole world is abuzz right now, talking about that epic encounter he had against his father at his 25th birthday show at PWF. And what a match that was.
Battle of the generations, and Adam Priest certainly a generous fighting champion, giving this guy a shot at humongous gold in his first match at New South.
And folks, if you have not seen that match between the Corinos, as soon as this is over, don't change that dial quite yet. As soon as Action Clash is over, make sure you seek that out right here on IWTV Video On Demand. Of course, you can find the New South back catalog there as well. Every episode of Action Clash available, as well as many of our special events. Right now, Colby Corino just wrenching back that modified surfboard stretch.
Bringing some of that technical skill against the champion, Adam Priest. And there's your homework for tonight at home. to go read up on this kid and just how much of an impact he's been making
Priest,
on independent though. Wrestling.
Priest loves him some technical wrestling.
Absolutely. Oh, look at that.
And that Indian lock. Now Colby making it to the ropes.
Priest darn near bending himself in half to put some torque on Corino.
It's impressive, the flexibility of Adam Priest.
Absolutely.
These two men feeling each other out. Priest locking that arm. Coming back down. Colby rolling through. It only takes a moment just like that, and we can have a brand new South champion.
Absolutely. And you're seeing the pace of two technical guys here. Certainly, the New South ring, certainly no stranger to a twisting, turning bout like this between two fellas that just know how to tie both themselves and their opponents in knots.
Oh, Priest with the bridge. Like I said, at a moment's notice, this match could go either way. That bridging pinning combination. Colby's shoulder is almost down for that three.
Two strong, flexible, physically fit fellas just going at it, Carmen.
This is what it's all about right here. Spirit of competition is alive and well in New South. Got that wrist lock. Oh, pushing back on the triceps, getting that extra torque.
Adam Priest certainly had those shoulders calibrated so he could torque them to spec, Carmen.
Think about all that pressure being put on the lats, being put on the tricep, on the shoulder. Colby, though, pulling his way through. Now it's cinched in that headlock.
Looking to put pressure on those joints, looking to...
Look at that. Look at the way he's leaning on and putting all of his
absolutely.
Weight.
Absolutely.
He's going to get every bit of leverage he can.
Put pressure on those joints, accumulate damage, take some of the mobility out of your opponent.
What a shoulder tackle. Looks like it took Colby by surprise, but it's like he's game though. He wants to play too. Flipping over. Scott, Adam Priest. Adam Priest left to lock in that sharpshooter. Colby, though, in the speed of Colby Corino, off the ropes, rolling through. Oh, my God. Oh, what a combination. Give these folks a hand here.
Carmen, we were a bumper's breadth from having a new South heavyweight champion.
This is professional wrestling at its finest, folks. These two men here, absolutely incredible.
Plenty of competition, plenty of athleticism, plenty of sportsmanship.
This is a match that I feel like any promotion in the country would be dying to have, but we have it right here in New South. Colby looking like he's taking this friendly competition and maybe switching his game plan up a little.
Certainly not feeling like he wants to play nice with our champion Adam Priest anymore.
But when it comes to the championship, comes that championship though, may cloud your morality a little bit.
Yeah. They say the lure of gold can do things to a man, Carmen, and we have certainly seen what the lure of human gold has made our New South competitors willing to do.
What was it? Proving to be a technical wrestling masterclass has quickly devolved. Oh my God! That DDT from Colby Corino to the floor.
You say devolved, but it certainly looks more like it's accelerated. Both men looking to put the hammer down, pick up the pace, and try to do a bit more damage to their opponent.
It's definitely switched to a different gear. Now, Colby Corino jaw-jacking with the fans.
Oh, well.
Ripping up that sign for Adam Priest.
Colby Corino.
I'm not sure they actually trained Adam. But if they did, I need to tell him he needs to get out of the way of this. Because this assault from Colby Corino just won't end.
Colby Corino sending whatever goodwill he had with the New South crowd off to the scrap heap.
Well, it's not about making the fans happy anymore. It's all about the gold.
That's what it's always been about.
Oh my God! Did you hear that? His hand has to be broken.
His entire hand right into that solid steel post.
He about chopped a hole through that post.
No matter how strong a body may be, it's simply no match for cold metal. Adam Priest with quick thinking, letting his opponent damage himself so he could take back control of this here match.
Priest quickly realizing Humongold is in jeopardy here. If things keep going Colby Carino's way. Adam, though, there's a reason he's New South champion.
Absolutely. He's willing to do anything he's got to do to protect Humongold.
Oh, my God. To prove your point. The human body is not supposed to contort that way.
No. The challenger proving that he's willing to go to that place.
One of these men is going to go the distance. But Colby Corino cannot win the championship on a count out. Championship's advantage. Remember that.
Absolutely.
Folks, he's going to have to break this count if he wants to earn that championship right there.
Got to get Adam Priest back in that ring and pin him for 1, 2, 3. That's the only way.
And Priest could take the easy way out and just take this count out loss and retain his championship. But Adam Priest is a fighting champion. He's going to get back in that ring.
You know he ain't going to take the easy way out.
Absolutely not.
Adam Priest is not one to let a good fight stall out like that.
He's got in that Steiner recliner.
Speaking of stalling, Colby Corino looking to stall Adam Priest's championship run.
Not looking to stall it, looking to put it to an absolute halt is what he's trying to do.
Certainly looking to slam on the brakes and bring Adam Priest's dreams crashing down, but Priest ain't going to go down without a fight.
If there's anything we know about Adam Priest is he will not go down without a fight. Beautiful suplex. And just, you see that? Not enough to put away Adam Priest, but if you notice that forearm just digging into the forehead of Adam Priest, just adding insult to injury.
Like Waltrip and Johnson in 64, trading position back and forth. Neither man able to really stay out ahead and keep control of this match.
Colby Corino just not letting up. It's a beautiful elbow drop, but not quite enough to put away our champion, Priest. Even when he's in a down position, still fighting back.
Absolutely. Corino, a young guy, but knows that he's got to put in combination attacks and pile that damage on to keep Adam Priest down.
That's the signal of a great fighter, too, there, Grease Monkey. When you're down on the floor and still fighting, not giving up whatsoever, Adam Priest now in firm control. Got the hips. Colby now locked in, going for that German suplex. Adam, quick reversal. Oh, Colby, though, rolling through.
Adam Priest not willing to give up that momentum, wanting to stay out ahead of his challenger.
Both men so skilled. And again, look at that. The way he leans onto the back of the neck of Adam Priest. That is how you do it, folks.
That is certainly how you take some of the wind out of anyone but Adam Priest.
That is how you chop a tree right there, going after the leg. And now, we've seen this many times from Adam Priest. That figure four leg lock.
Putting all that pressure on the hip, the knee.
And folks, they say, you know they say don't try this at home, but if you have ever felt this, you know just how painful it is. And when you have someone that's as much as a technician as Adam Priest, but hold on,
Somehow.
Colby Corino using Jesse.
Somehow Jesse Arbery.
Oh my God. The spin out package.
Oh.
Oh my God.
It's again Carmen.
Colby Corino almost walked in here and upset the New South faithful. Again, for those familiar with Colby Corino, you know his credentials. You know just how great of a professional wrestler he is. These folks in Gadsden, Alabama, maybe not as familiar with Colby Corino as those of you watching at home, but I promise you, if he would have won this match, there might have been a riot.
Bringing that pedigree into the ring of New South. Facing our champion like a man and really putting Adam Priest to the test here.
When you're a second generation wrestler like Colby Corino is, you gotta think your entire life you're picking up knowledge. So he's got a head start over just about everyone picking it up from the very beginning. Adam Priest, of course, still relatively new to the wrestling game, only been wrestling for about 4 years, but already so successful.
Absolutely. Growing up in a wrestling household.
Oh my God. No.
Got a
no,
little extra
no,
under
no,
the
no.
hood, but Adam Priest wanting to. Oh!
I was about to evacuate the premises. That Alabama Jam, almost. That tribute to beautiful Bobby Eaton, Alabama's own. But you gotta wonder the damage that Priest just did to his lower back.
He certainly could have done more damage to himself than his opponent with that. Landing as hard as he did from the top rope, you saw the hang time Priest can get.
Absolutely impressive the amount of air he got. Now back into the corner.
And there's that signature chop from Adam Priest.
Say, this is the Adam Priest we all know. They're going up top.
A skilled technical fighter, but also willing to just throw down.
Priest, that tenacity, not stopping just because Colby has him by the... Hold on. Oh. Into Yuri! German suplex, look at the bridge. When you have that bridge, just that extra little bit of leverage, sometimes it's all you need.
Definitely putting his full body weight. We love to see that beautiful bridge from Adam Priest.
Unfortunately for Priest though, not enough to put away Colby Corino. Again, two world-class athletes. These folks in Gadsden, Alabama are getting a treat.
Grease Monkey couldn't tell you what it's gonna take to put away a challenger like Corino. But Adam Priest certainly.
Oh, going for that DDT. Look at the way his head just snapped off the mat. That whiplash.
Priest thought he had an idea of what it would take, but Corino too quick, too smart for him.
Oh my God! I have never seen anything like that.
Corino busting out some moves, trying to finally put our champion Adam Priest down for good.
I wonder how much of that weight landed on that surgically repaired forearm of Adam Priest. Of course, we know there's a metal plate placing that left forearm. Colby charging in with that cannonball.
Grease Monkey's willing to say every pound of that weight went on it.
What's he have in mind? Oh my God! That corkscrew! Listen to the way that air just got sucked out of the crowd when they saw that hand going down, almost hitting the three. It's like all the energy just evaporated from the room. These folks do not want to see Adam Priest lose.
Grease Monkey about to have a misfire with all these near falls.
Oh, charging in. Oh, powerbomb! Action so hot in the ring that the lights are cutting off.
The sheer amount of ferocity blowing out the lights here. Adam Priest with that explosive power bomb. About near broke the ring in half, Carmen.
Colby Corino not where he wants to be here on the apron. Adam Priest has something dastardly in mind. Driver! Colby immediately grasping that neck. This man is in danger right now.
Adam Priest dropped every bit of Colby Corino onto that ring apron, one of the hardest parts in the entire ring.
And the importance of that New South Championship that we see right there, Grace Monkey. These two men are willing to stop at nothing.
No!
Oh, again! Targeting
the
that
hard
neck.
Floor.
The tenacity of Adam Priest. Oh,
the
signaling that again. That plate in the arm.
Oh, no.
Oh, rolling through.
Corino had it scouted.
That technical ability. Oh, what a kick. Colby signaling for the end, but still looking shook. Oh, I thought Colby was setting up for that sunsetter, but Priest fighting out. And again, that surgically repaired forearm. If he gets hit with this, that's a steel plate to the head. Oh, and the knee.
Corino simply not gonna let Adam Priest get in.
Things
with
are picking up. Oh, there we go. There we go. The forearm.
There it was.
A knockout blow.
Can't fault Adam Priest for
the winner of this match.
Every advantage he could
still
against the challenger.
South heavyweight champion.
Suffering the damage that accumulated over that match.